When I search for the term convert Excel file to PDF, all of these free online Excel to PDF converters pop up. You don't need them. Excel already has an inbuilt feature for that. I'm going to show you how you can use it, and I'm also going to give you some tips on creating perfect PDFs from your Excel files. Let me first quickly show you three different ways you can convert your Excel sheets or files into PDF. Number one method is just use the shortcut key Control P. This is going to bring up the print preview options, and you might find the option Microsoft Print to PDF in this dropdown right here. Then you can decide on whether you just want to print the active sheet, so the sheet I was on before I used the shortcut key, or print the entire workbook, or just print selection. So print selection is based on the cells that you highlighted before you came to this view. You might not want to print everything that's on that sheet. Now notice also that here it says print active sheets. So you can select multiple sheets and then go to your print options. So let's say I'm going to select index, hold down control, select the second one, and then go back to print preview, and I get both of them show up here in the order of the tabs. Okay, so that's method number one. The second method is to go to File, Export, select Create PDF, and then click on Create PDF. Give it a name, and then click on Publish. The last option, and this is the one I tend to use often, is to go to File, Save As, then from this dropdown, select PDF. Give it a name, and then click on Save. All of these options provide me with a nice PDF report. Now, all of that is nice, but what if I want to print these three tabs? So right here, I have a training tab. I have all these cells with dark gray in the background. I don't want them to be included in the PDF. I just want this white area included. Then I have this report, and I want this to be in landscape format. And this one should be vertical, but the data goes over many pages and people lose sight of the column headers. I want those included. If I go ahead and highlight these and do what we did before, I'm going to end up with a PDF that looks like this. Yeah, it doesn't look professional. Values are being cut off here and there are no page numbers. I wouldn't want to send this to my boss. It looks like I have no idea what I'm doing. The solution is super simple. It's called page setup. That's where you need to go to make the corrections you need. Let's do that quickly. Let's start correcting this sheet. If I go to print preview, notice that the page currently runs over to three pages and I have all these gray cells included. I don't want that. I only want to see the form. The solution is right here. Page layout, under page setup, you're going to find print area. That's what we need. But before we use this, we need to select our print area. So I'm just going to zoom out and then I'm just going to select the area that I want included and go to print area, set print area. Okay, so far so good. Now, if we go back to print preview, we don't see those gray cells anymore, but this is running over two pages and I don't want this stuff here. I can make this fit onto a single page. So notice under scale to fit, the scale is by default 100% and the width and height are set to automatic. Now you can adjust this or you can adjust the width and the height. So let's say I want the width to be 1 and I want the height to be 1 and the scale is automatically going to adjust to make it fit these requirements. So now if I go back to print preview, I get everything on a single page. Now whenever you're using this option, make sure that your scale isn't too low, right? Because otherwise everything is going to be very difficult to read. Now, another thing I want to add to this page are page numbers, because if you're printing more than one page, it really helps to add page numbers. We can do that from here as well. Just go to more options by clicking on this arrow, header and footer. For footer, we're going to add page numbers. I'm going to go with this version, page 1 of question mark. And then you can either just take a look at it in the print preview. Currently, it looks like this because I only have one sheet selected. If I had more, I would see 1 of 2, 1 of 3, and so on. Okay, so now let's move on to the next one. I want this sheet to be printed in landscape format. So currently, if I go to print preview, it looks like this. What I'm also losing is the information that I have in the first two columns, right? When I'm looking at these numbers, I have no idea what app they're referring to. So let's go and fix this. First of all, let's go to orientation and change this to landscape form. Next, let's go to print titles. Here you can define what rows or columns you want repeated. So in this case, I want the first two columns to be repeated. So we're just gonna go and select these two columns. And while we're here, let's go to header and footer and activate page numbers for this as well. And then click on OK. Now let's quickly take a look. We have page 1 of 2. When I go to the next page, these are repeated. But now it looks kind of weird when I have so much data on the first one and then just two columns on the other page. I want to split it so that the first page only shows me January data and all of this goes on the second page. I can fix that by managing my page breaks. I want a page break right here. Select the column, go to breaks, and insert a page break. Now when I go back to print preview, notice it looks a lot nicer. Now you can also view all the page breaks in the View tab under Page Break Preview, and you can adjust them if you need to by just dragging these. Now let's go to our last sheet. This one currently looks like this. It runs over 2 pages, and I'm losing the information on the column headers. I want to add these. I'm sure you know by now how to fix that, right? We're going to go back to Page Layout and select Print Titles. This time, I want to fix the rows that I want to repeat on top. So let's just go and select these ones. Let's go to Header and Footer as well and activate our page numbers and click on OK. Now let's take a look at all of these together. I'm going to hold down Control and select these 3 sheets. Control P to take a look at it in Print Preview. So I have 1 of 5. These are the sheets that I have in landscape form. And this is my last one. Okay, so everything looks great now. We can go ahead and print this to PDF. Now pick whichever option you prefer. You can save it as PDF, export it as PDF, or just print it directly from here. I'm going to call this one Nice Report. Let's quickly take a look at it. So what it comes down to is proper page setup. You can add the company logo as the header as well if you want, or add other information to the footer or header. Right, so you can modify these as you need. Just keep in mind that it doesn't matter whether you're printing these on paper or you're printing as PDF. You're going to need to have a proper page setup before you do that. As you can see, it's that simple to convert your Excel files to PDF. You don't have to upload your file to another external app to get it done, which can also be risky, especially if you have work data in there. Okay, so that was it for today. I hope you liked it. Do give it a thumbs up. Do subscribe if you're unsubscribed yet, and I'm going to see you in the next video.